Hey guys, welcome to my channel, The Mechanical Engineer. Here I am with another numerical from mechanical vibration. We have to find the natural frequency of oscillation for the roller rolling on a horizontal surface without slipping, as shown in the figure. The mass of the roller is 5 kg, radius of roller is 50 mm, stiffness of spring is 2000 Newton per meter. Now, what would be the new frequency of oscillation if the radius of roller is made 100 mm without changing the mass? So here we have a horizontal surface, we have a roller and the radius of the roller is 50 mm and the stiffness of this spring is 2000 Newton per meter. So now, in the second case, we increase the diameter of the roller to 100 mm without changing the mass and we have to find the new frequency. Now we denote the angular displacement of roller is equal to theta. Linear displacement of roller is x1. Linear velocity of roller x1 dot is equal to r theta dot. Linear acceleration of roller x1 double dot which is equal to r theta double dot. Now first we solve it using equilibrium method. So now considering linear motion of the roller, summation of inertia force plus external force mx double dot plus kr theta minus fr is equal to 0. Now guys, the fr over here is the frictional force the pulley will have over here with the horizontal surface. So it's the external force and its direction is opposite this side from mx double dot, so we take the sign negative. So now fr is equal to mx double dot plus kr theta. Now considering the rotary motion of roller, summation of inertia torque plus external forces. Now we have the inertia torque and in external forces we have the frictional force into radius is equal to 0. Now the inertia is equal to 1 by 2 mr square theta double dot and we'll substitute the value of frictional force is mx double dot plus kr theta into r is equal to 0. Now we multiply the r inside the bracket we get 1 by 2 mr square theta double dot plus mr square theta double dot plus kr square theta is equal to 0. Now we take theta double dot common from this equation, we get 1 by 2 mr square plus mr square into theta plus kr square theta is equal to 0. Now after solving this bracket we get 3 by 2 mr square theta double dot plus kr square theta is equal to 0. Now we send kr on this side and then we send 3 by 2 mr square on this side of the is equal to. Over here we get minus kr square by 3 by 2 mr square. Now we again take this whole equation on this side of is equal to we have theta double dot plus kr square by 3 by 2 mr square into theta is equal to 0. Now we take the 2 from the denominator of the denominator to the numerator we have 0 is equal to 2k upon 3m into theta plus theta double dot. We also cancel this r square. Now this is the differential equation of motion for a given system. Now we'll compare it with the fundamental equation of SHM, that is simple harmonic motion. Then we'll have omega n square is equal to 2k by 3m. Omega n is equal to 2k by 3m and its unit is radian per second. We'll have natural frequency is equal to omega n by 2 pi. We substitute the value of omega n. We have 1 by 2 pi root of 2k by 3m and its unit is hertz. Now we substitute the value given in the question. We get the natural frequency as 2.59 hertz. Now we solve it using another method, that is the energy method. In this energy method, first we have to find the kinetic energy and potential energy of this system. Now the kinetic energy, the linear kinetic energy of the roller is equal to half mx dot square, and we have the value of x dot is equal to r square theta square. The kinetic energy, the rotary kinetic energy of roller is 1 by 2 I 0 omega square, and we have the value of omega s theta dot and I 0 as 1 by 2 m r square. So we substitute all the values in this equation, we get 1 by 4 m r square theta dot square. Now the potential energy of spring is 1 by 2 k x square equal to 1 by 2 k r square theta square. We have substituted the value of x square as r square theta square in over here. Now the total kinetic energy is the summation of this both of these kinetic energies, and over here we have only one potential energy. Now according to the energy method, we have d by dt of kinetic energy plus potential energy is equal to 0. Now d by dt of 1 by 2 m r square theta dot square plus 1 by 4 m r square theta dot square plus 1 by 2 k r square theta square is equal to 0. Now we derivate this whole term. We get 1 by 2 m r square 2 theta dot theta double dot plus 1 by 4 m r square 2 theta dot theta double dot plus 1 by 2 k r square 2 theta theta dot is equal to 0. Now after doing all the cancellations and taking theta dot common from over here and throwing it on that side of the equal to, and it, at the end we get its value as 0. So now we have m r square theta double dot plus 1 by 2 m r square theta double dot plus k r square theta is equal to 0. Now we take theta double dot common from both these equations. We have m r square plus 1 by 2 m r square into theta double dot plus k r square theta is equal to 0. Now we further solve this equation. We get theta double dot plus k r square upon m r square plus m r square by 2 into theta is equal to 0. Then theta double dot is equal to k by 3 by 2 m into theta is equal to 0. The r square from here and this r square get cancelled over here, and then we put the 2 from the denominator of the denominator into the numerator, and we get the final value of this equation as theta double dot plus 2 k by 3 m into theta is equal to 0, which is same as a which we saw in the equilibrium method. So we will further solve it similarly. Now after solving that, we get the answer same as 2.59 hertz. That is because that the natural frequency of the oscillation of the roller is independent of its radius. Hence, even if the radius is increased to the 100 mm by keeping the mass same, the natural frequency remains unchanged. Thank you for watching my video. Have a nice day.